स्टार्ट। या आई एम नॉट स्पीकिंग राइट नाउ, आई एम स्पीकिंग ओके। सो इन द लास्ट क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस्ड रिगार्डिंग CSS, दैट इज कैस्केडेड स्टाइल शीट्स। ओके, देन देयर वी हैव सीन द लोकेशन ऑफ स्टाइल्स, वेयर यूअर CSS विल बी। आइदर इट मे बी प्रेजेंट इन द बॉडी सेक्शन बाय यूजिंग द स्टाइल इक्वल टू कीवर्ड, दैट इज कॉल्ड एज इनलाइन स्टाइल्स, or it may be present in the head section. So I will draw this. So let's see, I will write here. So inline, what do you mean by inline? So it is the style will be creating you in the body section. I will write here body open, body close. So this is called as inline. Okay, so here you have to use the style equal to, you have to write this. Okay, for the second one, that is embedded or internal level style sheet, where your code will go in the head section, head open and then head close, and in between this you have to use the style tag you have to use. In between this, whatever you can write, then close the style. So this is what the internal or embedded. And the third one is, this is the first one, I just make it mark. First one is the second one, and these two will be present in the HTML, and third I will write it as external CSS. That is, you are writing a different CSS file. That is, CSS file is created. Is it okay, guys? So this is how you are working with. Now, among this, so these two will be having this, will be having in the HTML file. Okay, HTML file, and this will be the other CSS file. Dot CSS file, you can say. .css file .html file. Is it okay? So just try to understand what are the things we are going to use in the inline. If you remember these three points, you can program anything in this CSS. Okay, so we will go for the next topic today. Okay, so location is done. Next one, then next we have yes, selectors. So already we have seen what is the selector. So whenever we want to go for any of the particular modification, for example, there are 3 to 4 H1s are there, headings. You know what is the H1? So 3 to 4 H1s are there, but I want only one H1 should be some different. Okay, in that case, I am writing the selectors, and this selector will be calling by using the class keyword within that particular tag. Okay, and very important, I will discuss once again what is the syntax of this CSS. So you have to use your selector name, which is nothing but the tag name, opening flower brace, then property 1 colon value 1 semicolon property 2 colon value 2 and so on. Is it okay? And this is completed. Similarly, so this is what the selector means, nothing but it is a HTML tag. So today we are going to discuss this HTML tag. Okay, then followed by I have to give this attribute 1 value 1 semicolon, attribute 2 colon value 2, and this one. If you remember this, today's class is dead easy for you. Is it okay? So many times they have asked, what are the different types of selectors. Okay, so what are the things you can include here. Is it fine? So first we will see, that is simple selector. Okay, so here you can see one hierarchy, HTML head and body. These are the two important parts in this HTML. Then the head meta will be there, that we have not used yet, we will use in the PHP programs. Then the title, so which will give the tab name. Yes. And after that, in the body, we have lots of tags or elements are there. Is it okay? So this is what the tree like structure. Okay, now within this element selector, the first one will be the element selector. Now what do you mean by element? In the first class only I have told tag and element both are same. Okay, means in this case you will get one element or one selector. Okay, so that is called as generic. For example, I can use here h1. Yes, h1. And what are the things I can do here for h1? Font hyphen size is, I can make 52 or 50 I can make. This is very simple. This is called as element selector. What is this h1? What are the two names for this? One is either a tag or either it is a element. Both are same. So this is called as element selector, guys. Is it okay? I think this is very simple, and it is also called as universal selector. Okay, so what it means? So wherever in your program, and you are storing this in the CSS file, in one of the CSS file. So I will make it here as, this is my style.css. This is my file. So within this file, I am writing this this particular code, and wherever h1 will come in any of this program, in any of the HTML program, wherever h1 will come, everywhere the font size will be 50. Yes, this is universal. Means if you have written one thing, it is applicable for all the h1s. It is just like how the default value for h1 it is a 36. That is called as universal. Now if you want to modify it, you can use your h1 as 50. Is it okay? So this is called as element selector. Is it okay, guys? So I think this is clear. First one, I will see this one with one example. Okay, the same example we can take as yesterday. That is a simple selector only, or element selector only. Say my CSS file is there. So within this body, now body will be only one, but h1, I will just remove this code and h1. So color will be red, margin is this 20 pixels, font size is 50 points. Okay, so wherever h1 comes in your external file, so it is going to be written like this. So I will write one more h1 here. Okay, then I will write here vsmsrkit. Okay, then I will close this h1. Now see, how many h1s are there? 2 h1s. And how many code I have written? Only for h1. Means wherever this h1 will be appearing, all the h1s will be replaced. Now what is the style I have applied for this h1? Font size is 50, color is red, margin left is 20 pixels. Is it okay? So I will remove this also. Paragraph also I will remove here. Okay. And this will be as it is. This will be the normal text. So if I run this, is that external HTML? So I will run open with Google Chrome. See here. This is the external CSS code in CSS external file, vsmsrkit. I have done this. Is it okay? So this is applied for, this is paragraph of, let me check this code. Why it has applied for paragraph tag? Okay, so this is what my HTML code, and this is a in headings. Okay, so both are same. I have written only once in CSS, that is for H1, and it has been applied for all the things. Okay, now what if I want this H1 should be of red font size, and then next will be this H1 should be something different. I want this should be blue. Okay, in that case, we are going for the next type of selector, that is your class selector. Okay, so class selector. So a class selector allows you to, I will just read this. A class selector allows you to simultaneously target different HTML elements regardless of their positions in the document tree. So wherever you can use, particularly you can use here. Now how to do that? Remember this, for the element selector we call it as a universal selector, and the symbol used is star. Please remember this. Okay, first selector is element selector, which is a universal selector, and it uses the symbol star. For this class selector, it is some specific, and it is used with the symbol dot. Okay, so dot symbol will be used. Okay, fine. Now let us see how it will work. So HTML body div we have. So just make a small change. I will just try here. So I will use. See, this is what the normal selector. I want to make this as the class selector. I will use here dot. Okay. So whenever I use dot, it will become the class selector. Okay, class selector. Then in the HTML file, I will use here h1 class equal to which, what is the class name that there? So I have to specify this class name. Sorry, let me check here once again. Example, let us check 3.4 as example. It is a group selector actually. So I have to use here class, that is example, this class selector. Yeah, directly they are using in the head section. Sorry, I have to use there in the this one. I will just copy this code. Line, what is that? Just paste this. Okay, and then I will use here body h1. So your style is there, style is open, style is closed. Done. Next one, I will make some class is equal to first. Okay, I have to give here class name as something else. So I will use here CSV as the class name, not the selector name. And here I will h1 class equal to CSV. Okay, so it can be applicable for all. Now let us just refresh this program. I have to check for internal inline.html. Here, welcome to VSM SRP IT. Now I have created the class called as c.csc. Why dot? Because it is a class selector. Second type of selector is class selector. There I am using the dot operator, and then I am using here class is equal to csc. Means whatever the modification done in the csc class, you know what is class, no? In your Java algorithm programs, you have created the different classes. Classes and objects. Okay. Similarly, here you have created the class, and that class will be called here. That is, class is equal to this CSC, and then you are going. Now, one thing you can see for this P also, you can use this class. So it's not case that you can create only the elements. Okay. So here also you call this CSC class. So this will be working fine. So this is also done. Any problem, guys? Any problem? Please don't talk and disturb, okay? Just concentrate, it's very important. So this is called as class selector, second one. So write the CSS code within the head section, within the style tag, and give the name of the class by using the dot operator. Very important, you have to give this dot operator. Okay, then this dot operator will be called as class. Then this class is equal to CSC. We just use this class so that all the changes will be appeared here. Okay, now I will make it as yellow color. I will make it as a yellow, and then just refresh, this color will become yellow. If you make one change, it will be applied for all. Wherever you are calling this particular class, everything will be called. If you delete this. If you do not use this particular class, okay, if you do not call this, so it will remain as it is. This is the inline CSS. Are you getting, guys? Yes, I think it is interesting, and you are getting also. Okay, you can give for anything else. Even if you say h6 is a tag, for h6 tag, what will be the default size? Say set of some 12. Okay, so I will use here CSC VHCMIT. I will write here. Just save this, refresh this. So this will be in the normal font. But if I include the same class for this, that is class is equal to, what is that, CSC class, then it will be again same. Is it okay? So you can write program once, means that CSS file once, and you can make modification for n number of elements. That is called as class selector. Class selector. Okay. Now next one. Third one we will see. See, first one is done. Element selector. Second one will be the class selector. Third one will be the ID selector. Now ID means what? Something special or some important and only particular, you can say. That is called an ID selector. An ID selector allows you to target a specific element by its ID attribute, regardless of its type of position. Okay, means one particular specific, that is called as ID selector. Okay, now let us see. Similarly, how you are using this class selector? You are using this dot operator. Yes, so here you are using some different notation for this. That is, you are using the hash. Hash and give the ID, say EC, I will create the ID this time, not CSC. Okay, and then I will show you this output. So I will use here color is equal to color. I will use here orange, and then font size I will use here say 40 points. Okay, these two changes are okay. So I will just remove this also, don't want any confusions. Only CSC, color is yellow, font size is 50 points. EC, color is orange, font size is 40. But what is the change here? So this is the class selector and this is the ID selector. Means if you return this class, it will be applicable for all. Okay, but what about this? If you call here, ID is equal to, say, ECE. If you do this, just change the here. So this is what the ID selector, and this is only one. Okay, this is only one. Next time, whenever you want to create, you have to create something different. Can you see this? This is the orange color now, and this will be changed. So this is what the ID selector. So let us see this example from the textbook. So this is a class selector. The class is used with the dot operator. Then the ID selector is used with this hash. Say here hash, then give any of the name of that particular class. So latest comment is the name of that. Then font style italic, color is red. So this you are going to include here. Div ID is equal to latest comment. And then I have taken for the h1 tag. He has taken for the div tag. Okay, but the usage of will be like this only. ID is equal to latest comment. Wherever you use this, all the things will be shown in this particular format. Div open, div close, until you have closed this, up to end this loop, this will be in the latest comment. Its color will be red, its font style will be italic. Is it okay, guys? So see this, these are the two things shown in this particular font. I think this is getting clear or not? Anybody? Please reply somebody. Is it okay or not? Three selectors till now we have discussed. One is the first one, element selector. Second one will be the class selector, which uses dot operator. Third one will be the ID selector, which uses the hash symbol or hash character. So three are done. Now next three are remaining now. So fourth one will be the attribute selector. Now what do you mean by attribute? You know what is attribute? it's a property, yes. So an attribute selector provides a way to select HTML element either by presence of an element attribute or by the value of the attributes. Okay, means here instead of using the element, you are using its attribute. Okay, now what are the elements and attributes? Can you tell me? If I consider one attribute, say img tag, and then I will use the src is equal to some value, then alt is equal to some text. Is it okay, guys? And this is self closing tag, so I will close this. So this is what my example. Within this, what are the things I can remember? This is the img is element, src is my attribute, and value is my value. Okay, so src and alt, these are what? These are my attributes. So fourth type of attribute selector is the attribute selector. Instead of making use of this, element, first was what? Element selector. No. Okay, first one was what? Element selector. First one was element selector. So this was the first one. First type of selector. Second one, we have created the values. We have created the class. Third one is ID created. Now the fourth type we are concentrating on using the attributes, not the elements. Okay, so these both are called as selector. So here it will be the attribute selector. Okay, so this is done. I will take one more example. Let me take the example of which tag? Link tag. We have used yesterday. You know, link, not link. It is not used because it is used in the head section. So better I will take the anchor tag. A href equal to some URL. Yes, and then nothing. So I will write here something. Some data, and then I will close this A tag, anchor tag. Okay, now in this case, what is this A? This A is element, yes, and this, what is this href? This is attribute selector. Is it okay? So instead of using this particular element or tag, I am making use of this property. It is called as what? Attribute selector. I think this is fine. This is clear, I think. Okay, so let us see now how he has demonstrated this. So here, title. So what is this title? So instead of making use of this title, directly he has used this title tag only. Sorry, this is attribute selector. No, yeah, it has to be correct. Image source, yes, here he has given here title tag. So what the thing he has given? Title cursor is equal to help type. Now how the help type cursor will be? Like hand thumb. Normally the cursor is what? This is a pointer, no? And this is a text selector. And when there will be one link, see, this is what? Help type. Okay, so this is what the help type cursor you can create. Whenever we use title, means when I take the cursor on this title, it will be, the cursor type will be help. Padding bottom will be 3 pixels. So this is what the padding bottom. You can see here at the down, the hand is very flat. That is called as padding bottom. Okay, then border bottom, that is also 2 pixels, dotted blue. Just you can see here, is it dotted blue? Yes, it is. Then you have text decoration is none. Don't do any decoration for this. This is called as style. And this style I am going to use in this src. Okay, so better I will copy this program and will execute this. So you can see the difference there. Okay, so just open Sublime Text and create new. Save this. What name I can give here? Say attribute attribute selector dot html. Okay, so I will write here html. I don't want all the code because already I have this code up to the body, head, meta, then meta I don't want, let it be. Okay, so I will just run this. Now what is there? This image should be there, but I don't have this image. I will use here a.amg file, then one more file a.jpg, and one more a.jpg. See, they have given their file locations, but I have only a.jpg file in my folder. That is, this is a.jpeg actually. It is, so we will make it as a.jpeg, jpeg, and jpeg. So I will save this and run attribute selector. Okay, now see here. Okay, so if I take the cursor on this, it is help. It is showing help, no question mark. Its cursor type is question mark, and its bottom is blue line. Blue line is there, dotted line is there. So this is about all the things. Means I am writing the code for the title tag. Title tag. Okay. So within the, if I write directly this title, so what it will be? What it will be? It will be what? It's a normal element selector it will be, but I, what is the concept here? Now it is a attribute selector. For the attribute I have to use here one square bracket. Is it okay guys? So this is what the change I can found in the attribute selector. Understood? So you can just refresh this and then you can see here. The same image here used 3 times. My a.jpg is nothing but my Google image, and it has the dotted line below this, and its color is blue, which is given in this particular line. Cursor is equal to help. Okay, so padding bottom is 3 pixels, border bottom is 2 pixels, dotted blue, text decoration is none. Okay, so this is about the attribute selector, and this title I have included here. Image source is equal to title flag ca.png. So this is not applicable for me. I will just remove this. I don't have that type of this one. Okay, and for the PHP also I don't have anything code. I just remove this. So Canada, then here source img source dot is equal to a.jpg title. So after this, this should come in front of this so that you can get it easily. Means this time this title acts as an attribute selector. Okay, see, what is this src? I will just copy this code. Okay, I will just copy this code and explain you in here. Sorry, just draw here a text box. Okay, so this is my code. Now I can note here. Now if you identify what are these img, 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 these are what tags? No, better I will write here within this. So what is this img? This is what the element. Yes, these are elements. So I can write here elements, but what topic we are discussing? It is a attribute selector. Now can you tell me what is this src? I will just make it like this. This title and this src, I will change its color. This one, I will make it like blue. Okay, and I will make here title and this src. Now what are these? These are my attributes. Yes, isn't it? These are my attributes. No, whatever the black box is there, that is about the element, and src is what, this is a normal selector attribute, and title, which is nothing but also a property which acts as a property. Is it okay guys? Are you getting this? Are you getting? I think you are getting this. Okay, fine. next one. So this is the title is done. Now coming for now, what are the things you can use there? One is, if it matches with the specific, then a specific attribute you can use here, like title. You can use the equal to operator, that is a specific attribute with a specific value. That is, title is equal to post from this country. Okay, now there are four values available. Post from this country, where it is? Actually not given here, but you can create by your own. Okay, then the equal to is there. Within not equal to, this is tilde symbol and equal to operator. Then starts with, okay, this is called as starts with something and equal to, it has. Star means which matches anything with this, and then dollar means which ends with this particular. So this is called as pattern matching. Okay, for example, A is a href anchor tag which has href is one of the property, yes or no? Then dollar means which ends with dot pdf. Yes, this is what one of the example. Then star means which matches with, wherever there is a flag, it matches it. Then next href, then you have mail to, which starts with mail to. Yes, then we have title is not equal to countries, which is not matching with this. Okay, then title equal to post from this particular country. So please remember, empty means it matches with all or a specific attribute. Equal to means it has a specific value. Tilde and equal to means it is not equal to, which it starts with, wherever there is a cap symbol, it starts with, begins with. Star means universal or a substring it has. Then dollar means it ends with. Is it okay? So this is what, these are the four types of selectors, very important selectors. Okay, so next one, we have pseudo element selector, pseudo element and pseudo class selectors. Now what are these? These are something special. Now what is the specialty? A pseudo element selector is a way to select something that does not exist explicitly as an element in the HTML document tree, but which is still a recognizable selectable object. Okay, actually pseudo means what? It is not available there, but there it will make feel of yes, there exists something. Is it okay? So this is what the pseudo element. And pseudo class selector means it does apply to an HTML element but targets either a particular state or in CSS3 a variety of family relationship. Okay, so the pseudo class will be available but targets with some particular. How you are using this class selector? No, same way pseudo class selector will be there. Okay, so let us see the examples. You can come with this example something. So A, then link. Okay, so A is what? It is the anchor tag, and link is one of the this one of the class. That is, A is related with this link. Yes, then A visited, then colon focus. So these are some different CSS elements are attributes are there that we were going to see one by one. So in the document object model, which is coming in the second module, we will see this all in detail. A link, now don't say this link is a tag, sir. So this link is a tag where in HTML, but we are discussing about the CSS. Okay, say A is a anchor tag, no doubt in that, but link is what? It's one of the attribute. So one tag and its attribute can be given as a pseudo class. Is it okay? And then A visited, visited also one of the binary tree, this one attribute, and it can be used with this pseudo class. So focus, if it is active, you can use this focus class. Okay, then hover, when you take the mouse on that is called as hover. Okay, this is one of the effect. You will study the one of the program on this. Then active, whether it is active or not. If it is coming at the front end, it is active. Then checked, there are different check elements, that is checkboxes are there, and if its value is checked, then it is called as pseudo class, that is checked one. Then similarly, first child is there, first letter is there, first line is there, many pseudo classes and many pseudo elements will be there. So just try to remember these all. These are the two extra classes, that is pseudo element and pseudo class selectors. Okay, is it fine? Pseudo element and pseudo class selectors. First we have discussed the four, and later we have these two selectors. So totally it is six. So in this topic we are learning two, pseudo element selector and pseudo class selector. So totally six. Write down the six selectors are there. Is it fine? Now let us see. Better I will run this program so that you can understand this very clearly. Copy. And I will make a new file here. I will just save this as sudo suedo dot html and I will just write html. I will just paste here. HTML head is open, head goes body, again head is open here, so I will not use this head. Only HTML open, I will give it here, head, then head is closed, body is open, then body is closed, one other body, I will close this body also. So just check out the code first, okay, so that you will not get any errors, I will just run this. What is the program name? Sudo. Okay, so I will use here sudo open with, sorry. Open with Google Chrome. So you can see here links are important. W3C. When I take the cursor on this, it is what? Something bold. Yes. And when I take the Canada, it is done. Then it has the underline first. When I take the cursor on this, its underline is going and it is becoming bold. Is it okay? So this is what the change. Now let us see the code. Let us analyze the code first. First one, a link. So link means what? It has the underline. Okay. When it has underline, text decoration is underline. You are making this. If you skip this statement, what will happen? So not this. Comment will be given like this. CSS comments will be like this only. Check. Comment in CSS. Yes, this is what the comment, multi-line comment you can give. So I will just refresh. Now all the underlines will go, just see, huh? Oh, sorry, it has not worked fine. No, this is HTML comment I have given. We'll make it, okay, we'll make it better. We will drop this line only. I'll just edit this. Now let us check. No, not like this. Over active, I have to make something change here. Visited, no, not visited. So this also we deleted. Save. Okay, let it be. We will check this. And link means what? Whenever it's change the color, at least let us see it open. I've done this before. Yes, the color is happening. Why I don't know about that link. So color becomes yellow wherever there is a link. Okay, so that link is wherever I'm using this link tag here. Okay, where is that yellow link? Actually list item, actually it is list item. So it is becoming the this one. Next one, a and visited. I have already visited that, then its color will become purple. If I click on that and I come to the come to back button, it will be purple. So I will click here and I will come back. It will become, now already it is visited. No, so just open with Google. So this color has been changed now because already it has been visited. Okay, so this is what the visited. Then hover, when you take the cursor on that, that's called as hover. Now my cursor is on hover, no, so this is called as hover. So text decoration is none and font weight becomes bold. Yes, it has become bold. No, when I take the cursor on this, United States. Now it is a normal and it has an underline and it's a blue. Now when I take the cursor on this, its color is becoming, it is becoming bold. So what one more thing I can add here is font size, it will be say 25 points. Okay, when I take the cursor on this, the font size should be big. Let us see and run how it will be. Yes, it has become more, no? So this is what the effect of the hover. Okay, hover is done. Then active, if it is active, it will be yellow, otherwise it is a green. So not green, it is a purple. Okay, then P, links are important part. So this is what the normal thing it is been used. Then wherever A is there, no? Now what is this A? This A is related with this particular A. Okay, so this A and this A both are same. So whenever its hover part will come, it will be performing all its hover actions. Okay, and this A will perform the link. Link will be there, so it will become, its color will become yellow. Okay, and when it is visited, its color will become purple. Is it okay, guys? Then list item we are creating one UL, unordered list. So LI, A, HRF. Wherever you use A, so all the things will be applicable. That it will be underlined with something, and then its color will be yellow. And when you take mouse cursor on that, A hover will be done. It's all things will be happening there. Is it okay? So for the Canada, Germany, and United States. And this is UL, and this is Neo body, and the HTML close. Is this fine, guys? Is it okay? Any doubts? Any doubts? Last 5 minutes remaining?
No, sir.
Okay, fine. I hope everybody is getting this.